Tesla, cost hoes, except truck. Hit him with pressure.
Yo, YouTube, what's going on? It's your boy Frank New. And I'm big with another one, big with another one, big with another one. You hear me? Hey, peep this out, man. Hey. They gonna have to do something about this, man. They gonna have to do something about this. I ain't gonna lie. Like, that money be consistent. But I don't like to sit in one spot. I do not like to sit in one spot. I like to get out, get gone, get back. Just that simple. This has been one of the most stressful weeks with USA. I ain't gonna lie to you. I ain't gonna lie. Y'all know I come raw. Ain't no beat around no bush. I give y'all these updates. This is the experience, you know what I'm saying? Like they say that you had your good weeks, you had your bad weeks. These trailers, man. Right now, we got a shortage of empty trailers. Ain't nowhere to get no empty from. Ain't nowhere to get no loaded one from. Like, it a lot of these places, like, you trying to get a loaded trailer, you got to take an empty in. Some of these places, like, I just went to Kimberly Clark and McDonald. I had a loaded pickup. No people told me. Well, you can't pick the load up because we ain't got no empties. And then come to find out that the load that I was given, I guess it switched carriers, so it became Warner's load. I don't know how the hell that happened. I ain't about to sit around here and worry about it. I'm about to take my ass home. You know what I'm saying? Somebody, I'm not going to speak on it, but I'm about to go to the crib. I've been chilling at the crib for the past couple days or whatever like that, about 3-4 days. Hey, I'm just about to call it, you know, it is what it is. I just don't understand, like, I was in North Carolina. I had a $7,000 week. Boom, they couldn't find me an empty nowhere, so I had to come off of two of my loads I already had. Then I turn around, found another load. Boom, you can't buy the tail end. So I had to try to find another empty. That ain't go right. So I was like, you know what? Close to the weekend, forget it. I'm going home. Get home. It's Sunday. Kimberly Claw. Normally, you know, we could just buy the tail end and we always got trailers there, whatever like that. It's a no-go. No-go. I don't know how they just did that. But if you go to a lot of these places, man, they just have our trailers just loaded. They don't empty them. They just be sitting on their yard, like storage. It's like, I feel like USA need to contact these people and tell them, bro, unload our trailers so our drivers will have trailers that they can pick up when they deliver a load. There should not be one reason why we deliver loads and cannot get it empty out of the same place. The thing is, if you ain't got no empty, you do not get your freight. You don't get your freight. That need to become a law, a rule, something that somebody's enforcing. If we got drivers coming in a day or two early, you know what I'm saying? Y'all need to have at least 3, 4, 5 trailers empty if y'all know how many shipments y'all got coming in from a specific carrier. Why we got to sit around waiting on loads? Wasting our hours, days, waiting on loads. Empty trailers. I don't get it. I really don't get it. This week right here has been the most frustrating. I ain't gonna say most frustrating. I really didn't get frustrated about it. I'm just like, it is what it is. But at the same time, some gonna have to give. Some gonna have to give. Cause most likely Monday I might have to pull a load off the yard just to get it empty. Or I might have to take one of these loads that ain't paying nothing. Go on the VA or something like that. Well, it ain't really too many loads coming up out of that. I just gotta figure this out. I gotta figure it out. This is the first time I ever dealt with this with USA. So I'm kind of like, I dealt with it with Swift. I dealt with it with Warner. I dealt with it, you know, all these other different little companies I've been at, especially Dart. Like, when I was with Dart, it was hard getting empties. But this week, it's a big no-go. I think last week, I probably only did one load, you know what I'm saying? Which I ain't really even tripping. Because, you know what I'm saying? It's like when you make a certain amount in 1 week, that can equal up to what, you know what I'm saying, somebody can make in a month, then it's kind of like you can slack off a little bit. Like, this one of them down weeks was like, all right, it ain't my fault that I ain't really grossing what I'm supposed to be grossing, but it's just with these trailers, I'm just trying to relax my mind and go ahead and hop in my whip and go to the crib, because I ain't got time. I ain't got time. And the thing is, it's a lot of drivers riding around here trying to look for empties. And then they got these company drivers that pull up with empties, and they're still attached to these empties for 3, 4, 5 days. Like, this is another part of consideration. Like, if I go home for 3 days, I'm dropping my empty, because another driver gonna come along and really need that empty while I'm at home chilling. If we kept that in rotation, some of this would kind of, you know what I'm saying, die down a little bit. Because you got, I'm not gonna count how many trucks it is right here, but bobtails, like, they just lined up, because it's a lot of people with no empty trailers. It's a lot of people. I just talked to two of them drivers right there, and I talked to a driver over here, and everybody need empties. But you do got these company trucks hooked up to empties, and it's like, bro, y'all go home. Let us get the empty trailers. You know what I'm saying? I just feel like this should make you drop that trailer. If you going home more than three days or whatever like that, drop the trailer. I see it's some of these trucks that's sitting up here that's attached to empty trailers, and I know for a fact they've been here 4 or 5 days. I know for a fact, because I've been off for a decent little minute. But I just want to run in and pass y'all. The thing is, when it comes down to this trucking industry, you're not going to have perfect weeks every week. You know what I'm saying? Some of y'all come over to USA or any trucking company, just feel like it's going to be like the quick money. You ain't going to run into no frustration, no slow time, no downfall, no nothing like that. You got weeks like that where you get that slowdown. It ain't your fault that you got that slowdown. But at the same time, it ain't nothing you could do about it. You just bounce back that next week. You know what I'm saying? And that's all I plan on doing. Because next week, I'm going to come out hauling eggs like I normally do and bring my butt right back home. Right back home. And somebody said, like, I should feel ashamed about saying cuss words and stuff in my videos and all that. Like, I don't. Truck drivers cuss all day, every day. Y'all hear more cuss words than I say. So I'm not gonna stick to that. But this has been one of them slow weeks over here at USA. And I'm about to have back here. Lay it down, cause I am slick too tired to drive to the crib. But I most definitely make it there in the morning. Y'all be safe at all times. Please like, share, subscribe, comment. It is your boy, Frank Nitty. We checking back out with another one.